very tender. Yeah, there's definitely no way that I would, if you hadn't told me, that I would know that this was grown in a lab, that it didn't come from a conventionally raised chicken. It tasted good and even had the fibers you'd expect, but the consistency was a little soft. Turns out growing animal cells is one thing, but reproducing the structure of fats, collagen, and blood vessels that give meat its texture is a big technological challenge. Scientists are still experimenting with scaffolds, as they're called, to give the meat structure. And there's another challenge. When you say to somebody, here's a piece of meat that was grown completely in a lab, some people might say, I'm not so sure about that. How do you get beyond that?
I think we should be realistic, and the industry should be realistic, that you just can't expect everybody to say, yes, I'm behind it. It's going to take time.
Despite the hurdles, Memphis has attracted more than $20 million of investment from big-name backers like Bill Gates, Richard Branson, and the food giant Cargill. Tyson Foods, one of the biggest meat producers in the world, has a minority stake in the company. Executive Vice President Amy Tu oversees Tyson's venture capital fund.
Our focus is on our traditional businesses, but we can't ignore the fact that the consumers are demanding different types of products. We want to be at the forefront of the future of food. So in order to do that, we may be looking at areas that may have been uncomfortable in the past.
Memphis Meats is not the only company now trying to make cell-based meat a commercial reality. In just the last few years, several startups have launched in the U.S. and around the world. The interest is spurred in part by growing concerns about sustainability, as meat production requires more resources than other foods. About one quarter of the world's ice-free land is used for livestock grazing. About a third of our cropland is used to grow livestock feed. And according to the UN, livestock production contributes almost 15% of the world's greenhouse gases, about the same as transportation.
More people eat meat tomorrow than they are today, and it's a big issue.
Josh Tetrick is the CEO of San Francisco-based food company Just Inc. The company began launching vegan food products in 2013. Its novel items like eggless eggs made from mung beans are available across the U.S. Just Inc. is now trying its hand at cell-based meat.
If there are so many issues with eating meat, then why continue to promote it?
People like eating meat, you know? It's just the way it is. If we can figure out a way to allow them to eat all the meat they want, just a different kind of better meat without all the issues, I just think that's the most pragmatic way to fix a problem. So this is our early research lab for our cultured meat project.
Biomedical engineer Vitor Santo is just the director of what's known as cellular agriculture.
I don't have any.
The process starts with a small biopsy of an animal.
It can be from a tiny piece of tissue, a small blood collection.
And the animal then walks away.
Exactly. So in this container, we have some of our chicken cells.
The chicken cells feed on a cocktail of proteins, sugars, and vitamins. The process also requires a substance to spur...
Susie, come! Where's Chloe?
Cows. Obtaining this fetal bovine serum is a huge obstacle to scaling up production. It's usually used in medical research, and it's expensive and controversial. It comes from slaughtered pregnant cows, which means for now, some of the cell-based meats made by Just Inc. and other companies aren't actually slaughter-free. Just Inc. is working to create a new plant-based alternative.
We really want to get rid of it for ethical reasons and also because it's very expensive.
Using the current process, it takes Santo about 2 weeks to produce this.
So this is our ground chicken meat, freshly harvested from